Hello, I'm Mihaela van der Schaar, and it is my great pleasure to give this invited talk in the Deep Generative Models Workshop at NeurIPS 2021. I'm going to talk today about the special use of deep generative models in creating synthetic data, and also I'm going to talk about assessment of such synthetic data. Our group's research agenda is to develop cutting-edge machine learning methods for revolutionizing healthcare. At NeurIPS 2021, you can see our work on developing analytics for healthcare, ranging from new methods for individualized treatment effect estimation to missing data. The outputs of such analytics need to be interpretable and trustworthy, so you see work from our lab also in this area. We have even created a new branch of machine learning dedicated to understanding and empowering human decisions with a focus on healthcare. And we call this new field quantitative epistemology. But none of this can be possible without high-quality healthcare data. In order to catalyze a complete transformation in healthcare using machine learning, we need high-quality data resources in the form of electronic health records, biobanks, or disease registries. But access to such data is complicated due to strict regulatory constraints. And this is the result of perfectly valid concerns regarding the privacy of such data. For instance, there is strong regulation coming from GDPR and HIPAA about the sharing of such data. So the lack of such high-quality healthcare data impedes our research in machine learning. One solution is to share data that was first anonymized or de-identified. But a key challenge associated with such data is that it is often either highly disclosive, and hence it shouldn't be shared with the machine learning researchers, or in other cases, it is of low quality because too many fields have been removed. So 5 years ago, we have proposed a totally different way to share data with machine learning researchers using synthetic data. And this is data created from scratch, which cannot be synced back to any individual if modeled properly. But this requires machine learning research. We are going to generate synthetic data to be used for machine learning modeling in healthcare and beyond. And this itself is a machine learning problem. So how can synthetic data help? In this way, we can generate on the basis of private data using generative models, synthetic data, which can then be shared with the machine learning community. The machine learning community can then generate on the basis of such data machine learning models, which can then be shared back and applied on the original data. So the uses for synthetic data range from developing analytics, as I mentioned before, to facilitating reproducibility of clinical studies and analysis, because the researchers do not only share their analysis, but also the data on the basis of which this analysis has been done. And this is often a challenge in healthcare research. Augmenting small data sets, for instance, for rare diseases or for underrepresented patient groups. And in this way, we can guard against model bias. More about this later in my talk. We can increase robustness and adaptability of machine learning models, for instance, by transferring using synthetic data across different hospitals and generating new data according to the characteristics of this new hospital, as well as simulate forward-looking data where we can even test new policies. More about this later in this talk. You can find an overview of our work on synthetic data over the past 5 years at our lab's research, where we have a pillar dedicated to this topic, and you can find many resources, a vision, several machine learning papers, as well as software associated with this. At ICML 2021, we also gave a tutorial, a comprehensive tutorial, about our past work in synthetic healthcare data generation and assessment. Please take a look. We are asking in this tutorial two key questions: how to build a machine learning model to generate synthetic data, and how to evaluate the quality of a synthetic data set. So the focus and desiderata of synthetic data generation is to enable generating synthetic data which has the statistical patterns created in such a way that it doesn't compromise the privacy of individual patients in the data set. So this is a twofold research agenda. On one hand, we have generative modeling, and on the other hand, we need to fulfill privacy requirements for the data that is generated. We have developed over the years a large variety of deep generative models that focus on synthetic data in healthcare. They can be divided in various classes, explicit likelihood models and implicit likelihood models. We have models that have exact likelihood or approximate likelihood, as well as models that are created using adversarial training or method of moments. You can see more about this on our website. Because there are many models and different models are needed for different purposes, we have recently generated a recipe for generating synthetic data. And this contains three key steps. First, we need to decide the generative modeling approach to use, for instance, GANs or normalizing flows. Then we need to construct an appropriate representation for the type of data under consideration. I'm going to give an example next from time series. And then in the third step, we need to incorporate the type of privacy required, for instance, differential privacy or other privacy notions. In fact, GDPR and HIPAA do not come with a rigorous mathematical formulation of the privacy required. And in one of our earlier works called ADS-GAN, we have defined according to HIPAA and GDPR and proposed a new notion of privacy based on key anonymity. Please take a look. Let us now focus on the second step. How can we generate data, synthetic data, for a specific modality, time series? The objective here is to generate time series data preserving temporal dynamics. And synthetic time series healthcare data generation is a primary example of such setting. But this is also true in finance, as well as many other settings where time series data is important. The challenge is to capture the distributions of features within each time point, as well as the complex dynamics of those variables across time points. And we have different ways to model synthetic data in time series depending on its need. For instance, we have created TimeGAN for data-driven high-dimensional data. We have created attentive state space models for interpretable settings where we have domain knowledge that requires information about states and states of disease and how they evolve over time. We have also created more recently Fourier flows, which is focusing on periodic data as well as irregular and variable length time series data, which is often the case in healthcare. But how do we know that data generated with these models or other models developed by other researchers are any good? We have created at NeurIPS 2020 a competition that we call Hide and Seek, which was organized by our lab in collaboration with Microsoft Research Cambridge and Amsterdam UMC. And the focus of this work was to create competitors in the form of hiders, which are generating synthetic data. And the data that we used was time series ICU data from UMC, Amsterdam UMC, and also seekers, which were aiming to re-identify patients in the original data set. So we had a two-sided platform with hiders generating data and seekers trying to re-identify the data. But in running this competition, we have learned some important lessons. And that is that defining the metrics for evaluating synthetic data, as well as the privacy preservation of such data, is hard. You can read more about this in the report and the paper associated with this competition. On the basis of the lessons learned, we have then developed a new research agenda on evaluating generative models. And we have learned that a single dimension metric is not enough. What we need is to evaluate model performance as a point in a three-dimensional space that contains and assesses fidelity related to how good the synthetic samples are, diversity, how much of the real data is covered and how representative that is, and generalization, how often does the model copy the training data. And for that, we have developed new probabilistic, interpretable, and multidimensional quantities for assessing such synthetic data. One particular concern is the fairness of synthetic data. And this is an important problem because unfair data can lead to unfair downstream predictions. So the aim has been to create fair synthetic data, which can be used to create fair prediction models. And in NeurIPS 2021, you can see our work called DCAF, which is aimed at generating fair synthetic data using causally aware generative networks. The challenges are removing protective attributes, and this is just not enough in many settings. We need to guarantee fairness of downstream model at the data level and preserve data utility at the same time while guaranteeing fairness. And there are different notions of fairness that we need to consider. So we have created DCAF, which uses a causal perspective to provide an intuitive guideline to achieve different notions of fairness. And fairness guarantees are given for the downstream setting. And DCAF is debiasing effectively. You can see more about this in our NeurIPS 2020 paper and associated presentation. So in summary, synthetic data represents an essential tool for developing analytics in healthcare, as well as in other applications that require privacy of the data. We can, using synthetic data, augment small data samples, improve model algorithms, and testing as well. And indeed, in Radial Gun a few years back, we have developed models which can increase the robustness and adaptability of machine learning models by transferring across different sites with different feature distributions and even feature distribution mismatch. As I've shown here, we have also created methods for evaluating synthetic data, and this represents a vibrant research agenda. We also can generate synthetic data that is fair and ethical. And in NeurIPS 2021, we also discussed how we can generate synthetic data that is forward-looking and enabled us to disentangle policies for real observational data, such that we can test in a simulation ecosystem that is synthetic yet realistic a variety of healthcare policies. Please take a look at our MedKit paper and NeurIPS 2021. And if you want to see more about our research in this area, take a look at our research pillars on our website dedicated to synthetic data. Thank you very much.